Hello, good morning students. Welcome once again to YouTube Learning Channel app conducted by Purna Chandra Residential High School, Baipada. So, in the previous classes, I have started the environmental issues of which segments of particulate matter. What? Particulate matter and control of air pollution. Under the control of air pollution, after the so 3 points I have given you so far. Now 1 point is left, that is what? Particulate matter. To control the particulate matter. So particulate matters are, so particulate matter. Separation of particulate matter from gases. Separation of particulate matter. Separation of particulate matter from gases. Okay? Now particulate matter. Separation of particulate matter from gases. Now two types of devices which are fitted in industries and automobiles. The two types of devices which are fitted in industries and automobiles. Now first is what? The arrestor. Arrestors. Now second one is catalytic converter. Catalytic converter. Now arrestors. Under arrestors, two devices are there. One is ESP and another one is scrubbers and catalytic converter. So arrestors are used in industrial purposes. It is used in industrial purposes. Which one? Arrestors. Now catalytic converter used in automobiles. Arrestors industrial purpose and catalytic converter automobiles. Now, so today I am going to explain ESP. What is ESP? It is a very important topic from the examination point of view. Electrostatic precipitator is very important. So, ESP. So what is called ESP? ESP, the full form of ESP is electrostatic precipitator. Now, so the full definitions of electrostatic precipitator, it is a device which is fitted in industries, thermal plant, so as to reduce the suspended particulate matter from the gases. Now it is a device which is fitted in industries, thermal plant, so as to reduce the suspended particulate matter from the gases, or it is also a conversion of gases from flue gases. Now you might be asking about what is flue gases. So flue gases, it is a very harmful gases having a It is a very harmful gas. Which gas? The flue gases. It is a very harmful gases constituting of dust, smoke, ash. Okay, it is a very harmful gases constituting of dust, smoke and ash. Now electrostatic precipitator will get separates the gases from flue gases. Now I am showing you the diagram of electrostatic precipitator. Electrostatic precipitator. So this is the diagram of, or this is the figure of a, or this is the figure of an electrostatic precipitator. Here all the flue gases. Which kind of gases? Flue gases. Flue gases is very toxic. If it is supposed to emit without the using of electrostatic precipitator, then these harmful gases will go to the atmosphere, which could lead to very harmful effects to water, plants, animals, as well as human also. Okay? Now flue gases, when it is entering flue gases to the electrostatic precipitator, what it happens? Now flue gases, the contents of flue gases is what is smoke, dust, ash. Okay? Now inside the electrostatic precipitator, two types of electrodes are there. Two types of electrodes. One is positive and another one is what? Negative. Two types of electrode. One is positive, another one is negative. So the thick one is positive electrode. Thick one is called a positive electrode. That is called a collecting electrode. It is called what? No, other name of this positive electrode is collecting electrode. Collecting electrode. And thinner one is discharge electrode. Discharge electrode. Thicker one is collecting electrode and thinner one is discharge electrode. So discharge electrode having negative charge and this is what? No, positive charge. Okay? Now all the gases, first the flue gases are entering to the electrostatic precipitator, and here a temporarily, or here a normal filter is placed. After entering the dust particles from this side, the suspended particles which are having a greater diameter, of the suspended particles will get settled down over here. Okay? And the rest of the gases will just pass from the filter to the inner part of the electrostatic precipitator. As we know, collecting electrode having water positive charge and discharge electrode having water negative charge. Okay? Now, so these two electrodes, now you might be asking about the question, what is the charge which it is having or which it is running in the electrodes? So these two electrodes having very high, so these two electrodes are fitted with high voltage current, right? So that is what, 20 to 70 kilovolt, 20 to 70 kilovolt, and runs on DC current. Which current? DC current. Okay, direct current. So discharge electrode positive, so this is collecting electrode, this is negative electrode. This is positive, negative. Positive is collecting electrode, negative is what? No, discharge electrode connected with what? No, 20 to 70 kilovolt of direct current. Now, these are having what? A positive charge. These are having what? A positive charge, and these are all having negative charge. These are all having negative charge. Positive charge, negative charge. Positive charge, negative charge.
Now, the gases, now it will go to the this side and this way. As well as also from the this way also. Okay? Now, when the gases having a suspended particulate having a diameter of, the suspended particulate diameter, suspended particulate diameter is 2.5 micrometer. So the suspended particulate matter goes inside having a diameter of what? 2.5 micro diameter. Now the discharge electrode, while it is entering to its, the discharge electrodes, now it will emit electrons. What it will emit? It will emit electrons. As you know, electron is what? Negatively charged. While it is entering, while the gases are entering the negative from the discharge electrode, it will emit what? Electron. It will emit what? Electron. Suppose the dust particle is entering in this way. So this is what? No? Dust particles. And the electrons will emit from the, well, and the electrons will emit from discharge electrodes. So I am showing you here. So this is the what? No? Negative electrode. This is negative electrode. And these are the dust particles. These are the dust particles. And they are, and here it is placed what? No? Positive electrode. Okay? Now segment wise I am explaining you. This is discharge electrode. Discharge electrode, and this is collecting electrode. Collecting electrode. Discharge electrode and collecting electrode. Now these dust particles are passing through it. As the dust particle is passing through this channel, now the discharge electrode will emit what? Electron. What it will emit? Suppose this is one of dust particles. This is dust particles. Now, while the electrons are getting discharged from the discharge electrodes, now the electrons will surround the dust particles. As we know, this is what? Negatively charged particles. Which one? Electrons. Now it will surround the dust particles, forming what? No? Corona. What it forms? Discharge corona. What it forms? Discharge corona. Discharge corona. What it is forming? Discharge corona. So it is converting the dust particle into what? Discharge corona. As electrons are surrounding what? Dust particles. So the dust particles will now get what? Discharge corona. And these particles will source negatively charged. And these particles will behave like negative charge. The particle, the discharge corona, behaves like negative charge. Behaves like negative charge. As it is behaving like negative charge, as we know, collecting electrode is what? Positive electrode. Now negative charge, so the negative charge discharge corona will get associated to the collecting electrode. Now it will get associated to the collecting electrodes and will be letting the cleaner air from the chamber. Cleaner air. Okay? This is positive electrode. Positive electrode is for the collecting electrode, and this is negative electrode, that is for the discharge electrode. As the dust is passing through it, now electrons will emit from the discharge electrodes, and which kind of force is taking place in it? Electrostatic force. Which kind of force? Electrostatic force. Did you have ever experimented anything like polythene seeds? While rubbing the polythene seeds, and you are just placing to the paper, and the paper will get attracted to the what? No? Polythene seeds. So which kind of force is exerting over there? Electrostatic force. Likewise, electrostatic force is also electrostatic force is also behaving over here. Okay? Now, the negatively charged corona will get associated to the collecting electrode. As the discharge corona is associating to the positive electrode, the cleaner air will comes out from the electrostatic precipitator. Clear? As the cleaner fuel, and which kind of force? Again, I am showing you, that is electrostatic force. Which kind of force? Electrostatic So this is a neat question. If a question is arising, what kind of force is present inside the electrostatic precipitator? No. Now you will be answering that the electrostatic force is functioning over here. Okay. Now the cleaner air. The cleaner air is going to the atmosphere now. The cleaner air will go to the atmosphere. And the cleaner air, what percent the cleaner air is going to the atmosphere? 99%. What percent? 99%. Okay? By this way. After this, here the positive electrode. And due to some striking on the electrode and the striking of electrodes, on the striking of electrodes on the positive electrode, now this this dust particles will gets settled down over here, and these particles will get settled down over here. Okay, these are the discharge corona particles. These are the before it was discharge corona particles. While it is associating the electrodes and let the currents to be stopped, and these particles will get settled down at the base chamber. Okay, this is the functions of electrostatic precipitator. Now, such kind of electrostatic precipitator was employed in every industries and thermal plant from 1974. As the government has passed the bill for the purification of air in industries. So as the government has passed the bill for the purification of air in industry in 1974, by which norm? That is what? No, CPCB, Environment Protection Act, which was implemented earlier in 1986. So what is the full form of CPCB? CPCB, Central Pollution Control Board. Central Pollution Control Board. Okay, now ESP is over. It is very important topic, so you have to learn it nicely. Now next is catalytic converter. Scrubber is not needed. Now catalytic converter, it is an important part. Catalytic converter. Catalytic converter. It is a device which is mainly fitted in an automobiles like buses, fitted in automobiles running by petrol or diesel. Catalytic converter. Now, catalytic converter, it is a device which is mainly fitted in an automobile running by petrol or diesel. So the metals which it is used in, the metal which it is used in catalytic converters are what? Platinum, palladium and rhodium. The metals which are used in, the metals which are used in catalytic converter are platinum, palladium and rhodium. Platinum, palladium and rhodium. These are the very expensive metal. These are all expensive metal. The functions of catalytic converter is to convert. So what is the functions of catalytic converter? The main function of catalytic converter is to convert the harmful hydrocarbon gases, carbon monoxide and nitrogen monoxide into another gases. Clear? That is called what? Catalytic converter. So catalytic converter is to convert the harmful gases to harmless gases, which it is fitted in an automobile. Suppose this is the diagram of an automobile. Sorry, sir. So this is the diagram of a catalytic converter. This is the diagram of a catalytic converter. Here, the metals, platinum, palladium and rhodium are placed. Now the harmful gases, like which kind of gases? Hydrocarbon, nitrogen monoxide, carbon monoxide, these are all harmful gases. While it is entering to the catalytic converter, the hydrocarbon gas is converting into what? Water and carbon dioxide. The main function of platinum, palladium and rhodium is to convert the hydrocarbon gases to water and carbon dioxide. Another one is NO plus CO. These are very highly poisonous gases. While it is reacting with the catalyst, like platinum, palladium, rhodium, it is getting converted to what? CO2 plus N2. Now you balance, you have to balance now. 2. Balanced. Okay? So this is the reaction site. This is the reactions which takes place inside the catalytic converter. Okay? So the metals which are used in catalytic converter, platinum, palladium, rhodium. Now, this catalytic converter can only be usable under unleaded petrol. Unleaded petrol. If the catalytic, if catalytic converter is supposed to be run with leaded petrol, then the catalytic converter, then the metals like platinum, palladium, rhodium, which are present in catalytic converter, will become inactive. Okay, this catalytic converter can only be usable under unleaded petrol if catalytic converter is used to run the engines with leaded petrol or diesel, the catalyst will become inactive. The catalyst will become inactive, become inactive. Once again, everybody. Catalytic converter. It is a device which is mainly fitted in an automobile running by petrol or diesel. The metals which are used in catalytic converters are platinum, palladium, and rhodium. These three metals are very expensive metals. These catalytic converters can only be usable under unleaded petrol. If catalytic converter is used to run the engine with leaded petrol or diesel, the catalyst will become inactive. Okay? So the reaction taking place inside the catalytic converter is hydrocarbon forming water and carbon dioxide, nitrogen monoxide and carbon monoxide reacting to form water, carbon dioxide and nitrogen. Carbon dioxide and nitrogen, these are the gases which are present abundant in the atmosphere, which are very harmless. Okay, so the function of catalytic converter is to convert the harmful gases into harmless gases. Okay, finished.